From the previous 5 videos, we implemented routing and understood how routing works. We were able to display 2 different components by manually modifying the URL in the browser address bar. In this video, I will demonstrate how to implement navigation links so that we don't have to manually change in the address bar. I have already made necessary changes in the code. I will demonstrate how it works in the page. In the top of the page, we can see 2 links, Getting Started and Attribute Directive. When I click on the respective link, we can see that the respective component displayed below the links. To make this work, I have included 2 lines in app.component.html above the router-outlet tag. The first anchor tag is for Getting Started component and the second one for Attribute Directive component. In each anchor tag, notice the inclusion of routerLink attribute. This is an attribute directive available in router module. In router.d.ts, we can see routerLink attribute directive loaded by router module. Coming back to the anchor tag, let us look into the value of routerLink directive. It should have a slash followed by the path name defined in the routes. For example, one of the root path name is getting-started, which is what is included as value in the first anchor tag's routerLink attribute. The routerLink directive uses this value to navigate to the respective component. Hope this clarifies how routerLink works. To implement this in your Angular application, include these 2 lines in app.component.html and check if it works as expected. Notice the inclusion of ampersand NBSP semicolon. This includes a space between the anchor tags. In the next video, we will understand how routing helps in code reusability.